Good morning, Chapter 7. I am going to continue Chapter 4, Atoms, Molecules and Radical. Dear student, in this video I am going to explain a new topic, relationship between the valency of element and periodic table. Dear student, in previous video I explained you about valency. What do you mean by valency? Combining capacity of an element or of a radical is known as valency. Element you know very well, pure substance are known as element, which are made up of single kind of atom are known as element. Periodic table. What do you mean by periodic table? Periodic table is a tabular arrangement of element in vertical column and horizontal row, indicating the regular trend in the property of the elements. Dear student, in this topic I will explain you how elements are arranged in the periodic table. Till now we are aware about 118 elements, but dear student, in this video I will explain you atomic number 1 to 20 how to arrange in the periodic table. So please pay attention to the serial number, atomic number 1 to 20, the elements. Atomic number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19 and 20. Now see the, I am going to give you the sample of the element. Denoted by S. Hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon, sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine, argon, potassium, and the last is the calcium. Here hydrogen 1, helium 2, lithium 3, beryllium 4, boron 5, carbon 6, nitrogen 7, oxygen 8, fluorine 9, neon 10, sodium 11, magnesium 12, aluminium 13, silicon 14, phosphorus 15, sulfur 16, chlorine 17, argon 18, potassium 19 and calcium last is the 20. Now I am going to give you the mass number. Mass number of hydrogen is 1. Hydrogen atomic number and the mass number is the same. Helium 4, lithium 7, beryllium 9, boron 11, carbon 12, nitrogen 14, oxygen 16, fluorine 19, neon 20, sodium 23, magnesium 24, aluminium 27, silicon 28, phosphorus 31, sulfur 32, chlorine 35.5, argon 40, potassium 39, and calcium the mass number is 40. So dear student, these are the atomic number 1 to 20 I have arranged here, and according to that I have put the symbol. You can see here hydrogen as a symbol is the H. Now I am going to explain you how this element are placed in the periodic table. So pay attention. Okay, so here I have made the 8 groups. Group 1A, group 2A, group 3A, group 4A, group 5A, group 6A, group 7A, and here the element will be placed which are of the zero valency. Zero valency elements are known as inert gas. Reason behind it, they are stable in the nature. So dear student, one by one I am going to explain you how this element are placed in the periodic table. So dear student, two columns are here. One is the vertical column known as group, whereas the horizontal, you can see here, horizontal rows are here. Horizontal row are known as period. These are known as period. So four period. 1, 2, 3, 4. Four period it is being placed here because the main in an atom four cells are there, and according to the cell only the period are being recognized, or it is being denoted, or it is being given to the particular element. So now I am going to explain you, now the group of an element can be known by its valence electron. If the valence electron of a particular element is 2, then it will be placed in the group 2A. If it is 3, then placed in the 3, same way. So now I am going to explain you about, according to the atomic number, the electronic configuration is being done. And in the previous video I explained you how to do electronic configuration, and by the electronic configuration only we are able to know about valence shell, valence electron, and also we can find the valency of the particular elements. So now I am going to explain it. See here, these are the cell KLMN. Now I am going to make the electronic configuration of the particular element hydrogen. Hydrogen has only one atomic number is 1. So if we do the electronic configuration, only one cell required to keep the a single electron. So hydrogen will be placed in group 1 here, and also in the period 1. Reason behind it, group 1, because it has only one electron, one valence electron, and for the electronic configuration only one cell required. Due to that, hydrogen is placed in the group 1A. Let us see the helium. Helium, you see 2, dear student, as it 2, and it is the inert gas. So inert gas, and it required only one cell. So this helium is placed in the period 1, and the due to the zero valency, it will be placed in the, here the zero valency first, in the first period. Reason behind it, it requires only one cell for the electronic configuration. Next you see the lithium, 3, 2 and 1. As for the electronic configuration, two cells are required. Due to that, the lithium will be placed in the second period, where the group will be 1. You can see here, lithium is placed here in the period second, because two cells are required for the electronic configuration of the atomic number 3. And due to the valence electron, due to that it will be placed in group 1A. Next you see the beryllium, 4, 2, 2, as the two cells are required, so it will be placed in the second period, but the group will be 2. Group 2. So beryllium is placed here. Next you see the boron, 5, 2 and 3, as it will be a 3 valence electron, so it will be placed in the group 3A, and but the period will be the 2 only, in the second period, but the group will be 3A. Next you see carbon, 2 and 4, as it will be placed in the second period, but the group will be 4. So next you see the nitrogen, the atomic number 7, 2 and 5, so it will be placed in the fifth group, and the period is second only. Next you see the fluorine, you see 19, the mass number, but the atomic number is 9. So 2 and 7 is the, okay, 2 and 7, so it will be placed, fluorine will be placed in the 7A. Next you can see here, one is being left, oxygen I have left here, you see the oxygen, 2 and 6, so oxygen will be placed in the 6A group. Reason behind it, outermost valence electron is 6. Next you can see here, as I explained you about the fluorine placed in 7A group. Next you see neon, 2 and 8, it is a stable element, so it will be placed in the second period, so it will be here, helium, neon. Next you can see sodium 11, 2 and you can see here 2, 8 and one more, means for the electronic configuration of the sodium it require 3 cells. So now the sodium will be placed in the third period, but the group will be 1. So dear student, those elements whose valence electron is 1, they will be placed in a group 1A. Whose valence electron will be 2, it will be placed in the group 2A, and this way. Now see, magnesium, 2, 8 and 2. It will be placed in third period, but the group will be 2. So you see the aluminium 283, it will placed in the third group and third period. Silicon 2, 8, and 4, it will place in the fourth one and third period. Next you see phosphorus 2, 8, 5 in the fifth group. Here below the nitrogen it will be placed. Next you see sulfur 2, 8, and 6 in the sulfur will be placed here. Next you see chlorine 2, 8, 7 Cl. Next you see the argon. Argon the atomic number is 18. So 2, 8, 8, 18. As the argon is the inert gas, so it will be placed here in the zero balancing Ar, and the period will be third. Next you see potassium 2, 8, 8, and 1. Dear student, you can see here for the electronic configuration four cell are required. Due to that, potassium is placed in the fourth period, but the group will be 1. Reason behind it, the outermost valence electron is 1. So potassium is placed in the fourth period, but the group is 1 only. Next you see the calcium 2, 8, 8, 2 placed in second group, but period is the 4. So calcium is here. So dear student, I hope you understood it, how to place the element atomic number 1 to 20 in the periodic table. I hope, no doubt, just you practice it and try to understand it. Thank you dear students.